Welcome back to the channel. Today we are going to cook, and we are going to cook a nice, warm, cozy meal. And I can't think of anything better than a nice, warm meal on a cold March day. March is the host of St. Patrick's Day. And in preparation for my trip to go to Ireland, I have immersed myself in culinary arts of Ireland, history of Ireland, castles, cliffs. I am looking forward to it. And I was very inspired today to create for you a delicious meal from thanks to Ireland. It's called Colcannon potatoes and bangers. Stick around for the Guinness gravy. So basically it's bangers and mash, Irish style, which Colcannon has the greens put within them. And traditionally it was cabbage, but I'm doing a little twist on that. Let's start cooking. A bit of a detour today. I actually, on top of bangers and mash, I had one of those Costco chickens. And my son finished the chicken off for lunch, but I had the carcass. And sometimes I just get rid of the carcass, and sometimes I like to use it to make some broth. And that is just easy. Put water to the top of the carcass, some cloves of garlic, some onion, celery, and carrot. And so the broth, I think I'm gonna do like mini tortellini. Okay, let's get started with the Colcannon potatoes. They're mashed potatoes brought to you by Ireland. So this is an interesting tool. It cleans off the kale. Let's see. Yeah, that's pretty good. It did come off most of the stem. I guess I could put it in a smaller one. Let's just try. Oh yeah, this is the stem is that size. So cool. When it comes to the top, it's not as clean, but that's all right. Typically what's used is cabbage, and I have Savoy cabbage, and I am going to use probably a third of this gorgeous. Isn't that beautiful? I just love Savoy cabbage. It's great in minestrone. You have kale that I'm just cleaning off. Other things, I'm gonna dice up the onion. I have some green onion and some garlic. Behind me, I'm gonna put some butter, olive oil behind me. And I have the potato, this salted water behind me. And I'm going to peel about, I have eight. If you had larger potatoes, I would only use six for like that amount of ingredients. That was about six stalks of curly kale. All right, we're going to saute all of these things. I'm going to swing you over, bring you over here. Cook the kale and Savoy cabbage. I've got some onions, green onions and garlic in this. Salt and pepper. Okay, that's sizzling nicely. I'm gonna add in the kale and Savoy cabbage. And of course it will wilt. I have a half a cup of cream and about two tablespoons of butter. And you get that cooking on a low, low. In this one, I'm gonna put some garlic and onion. Okay. Okay, so what we've got going on now is the kale and cabbage is sauteed in the butter and oil, salt and pepper, garlic, green onions, right? And onions. The potatoes are still, it's been about 15 minutes and they're still cooking. So the cream and butter melded together beautifully, and I put some garlic and green onions in that, so that's ready for the mashed potatoes when I put that together. Next step is the Guinness with bangers. So I went to my deli yesterday. Oh, nice, right? Fresh sausages. So sausages will saute in red onion. I have some shallots here that I'm gonna chop up. And that's all, because I'll put a little bit of garlic inside of the gravy, which will be Guinness gravy. Okay, doesn't that look nice? Colcannon potatoes, ready a few hours before my guests come. So I'm just gonna put a tin foil over that and then put it in an oven to pre-warm. This is what I'm gonna put the bangers in. So let's get started on removing the bangers and putting them in here. And let's get started on the gravy.